Did you know that people are getting randomly banned on Discord because you can basically ban whoever the heck you want? And the worst, or best part, depending on how evil you are, is that they can't appeal this ban because Discord support is awful. So, how are people getting randomly banned? Well,
here's a little lesson in trickery.
I have a friend here. Just kidding, this is my alt account because I don't want anyone getting banned, but I am going to ask them, how many eggs are in a dozen? 12. Quite a strange question, but if you wait a while, maybe wait a couple of hours until they forget, all you need to do is just edit this cute little message to say, how old are you? And now, boom. Try sending that to Discord support. Now, this is a pretty obvious example, and to be honest, my examples aren't going to be the best because I don't want to inadvertently make this a tutorial, but if you didn't know, Discord doesn't allow people under 13 on the platform. And if you are in some of these countries, it's even above 13 at some point. But generally speaking, if you are 12, you are not allowed on Discord. But here's the thing, people very frequently do get banned, even if they are 13 and above, for being underage. It doesn't make sense, but if someone doesn't like you, all they really need to do is just sift through your messages and see if there's anything they can take out of context and send to Discord Trust and Safety. Of course, for me, there's nothing except Mert sitting in the most ergonomic position on the planet. God, I love talking about this guy. It's literally my passion at this point. But as long as there is a questionable message by someone that involves anything around being underaged or minors, kaboom, you can report that to Discord and they will get banned. Now, going back to my sick, awesome simulation of a normal, totally normal Discord conversation, let's say I ask someone, can you drink? Of course, this is a pretty typical question to ask anyone because maybe I could follow up with what's your favorite type of alcohol, but your response is, well, you're 18, you're not actually above the legal age of 21 to drink in the United States, so you say, no, I'm underage. You now have a message that you can report to Discord Trust and Safety and twist the context into saying that this person is underage, they're under 13, and they cannot be on the platform. So this is a big public service announcement warning, but please just be very specific with your messages when it involves numbers and if it involves being underage. You need to make sure you have context in the same message, or else you could be falling into a trap of being falsely banned. Also, when you get banned for being falsely underage, there's only one thing you can do, and it's completely awful, and I'll talk about it a little bit later. Also, this type of false report doesn't just work on users. In fact, it can work on Discord servers. One of my viewers actually made a video suggestion talking about how Trust and Safety did absolutely nothing, because a server that they used to moderate just got randomly deleted, and all 5 staff members' accounts were disabled with no warning. So make sure to moderate your chat properly and ban people who are talking about being underage or anything about being single and dating and that stuff, or else Discord support will get you. Now, this whole situation is honestly a perfect storm because Discord has an absolutely garbage support system. And it's not just me that's complaining. In fact, one of my viewers said, the Discord staff are all money-hungry mother. They don't give a about support at all because all they care about is money. Now, of course, this is a very biased opinion, but if you go on Discord's own feedback system, there are people that are also complaining about Discord support being absolute garbage. And when people get banned randomly, they go through the 5 stages of grief. We have denial. Disabled account for no reason. My account has been deactivated for no reason. I think I am a victim of mass reporting. That is denial. We now have anger. Discord support is awful. And we have even more anger of someone suggesting a class action lawsuit. And the next stage is bargaining. Would Discord ask for my password? Oh wait, no, this is actually just a scam. Yeah, there's a lot of scam posts on this feedback forum, actually. It's quite entertaining. And after bargaining, we have depression. Will Discord ever care? But then we end up on acceptance. Got hacked and there's no sign of support. Here's the thing. The way that Discord support really works is that you have 3 possible things that can happen. They can respond to your ticket and you actually get support, which is extremely rare. But usually what happens is that Discord support will just close your tickets out of nowhere. And it's not just one person. In fact, a lot of people are complaining that their tickets are just being repeatedly closed with absolutely no response. But if they don't close your ticket right away, you might be lucky because you might just have to wait weeks and weeks on end because the support team just hasn't responded in 7 days. Unimaginably slow. Someone's been ignored for 2 weeks. And finally, the cream of the crop, really, someone has been ignored for 20 days. So if you ever wonder why people are extremely upset about Discord support, especially with this post here, is because there are people that have been completely ignored, and it feels like no one's actually getting heard for their issues. Now, one thing to note about Discord's Trust and Safety team is that they are outsourced. So basically, Discord contracts a company, meaning that they pay a company to be in charge of dealing with trust and safety tickets. Now, that contracted company will then hire a whole bunch of people for trust and safety, and they'll find people to deal with the absolute mountain of support tickets that Discord gets. And the reason why things really haven't been fixed is because usually when you outsource something, you are doing it to cut costs, because the work is from other countries where wages are cheaper. It really feels like Discord's being quite cheap here, because there should be a lot of people that you can hire to fix this issue, but it just seems like Discord is always constantly overwhelmed. Now, not every outsourced support team is bad. For example, I've personally had a fantastic customer support experience from Amazon, and they are 100% outsourced. Of course, Amazon is a massive, massive company, but they have the proper systems and management in place to make sure that the support team runs incredibly smoothly. And for Discord, you might want to get mad at the person that's helping you. For example, this person here says, "I sure hope your ticket won't be assigned to Marengo," which, by the way, I've had some good support tickets with Marengo. But getting mad at the person that's helping you does absolutely nothing, because the problem really does lie with Discord's upper management team, and I don't know what the exact issue is with Discord support and why it's so bad, but Discord, figure it out. It's not my job to tell you what to do. And a great way to illustrate that the support team and the systems in place aren't working is that Discord's support system, it really relies on message links. This is a blog post by Discord's trust and safety team telling you how to contact Discord Trust and Safety. And literally the whole article is, how do you get a message link? The whole entire Discord report system requires a message link. Now, where this issue really shines is that if you want to report a bad server, so for example, you have some sort of NSFW server, you do not want to join it, but you want to report it so that Discord takes it down. Well, there's no message links you can get unless you join the server, so there's like nothing you can do. It's stupid. And I talked about this in a previous video, so I'll gloss over it, but if your issue, if you're reporting someone for something in their About Me, someone made a ticket about it saying, look, this person's underage, and Discord asked for a message link. You can't get a message link from an About Me profile. What is going on? Now, I want to talk about desperation, because here's the thing. When you get your Discord account disabled, you only have 14 days before your data is completely nuked off the platform. Furthermore, please note that the data associated with deleted accounts are deleted or anonymized 14 days after beginning the deletion process for that account. So you have 14 days. Minor correction, from what I saw, it seems like it's between 14 and 30 days, and this is obviously problematic because there are people that get completely ghosted by Discord. They have that 14-day doom timer, and they are getting extremely, extremely impatient that Discord is not responding to them. And what happens when people get impatient? Well, they start getting irritated and angry, and they start making posts like this, which does absolutely nothing. But when they don't hear anything back, they'll start making more and more tickets, which are usually just rants and completely worthless to read, and Discord will close it because it's either a duplicate ticket or it makes no sense, and that makes people even more angry and impatient, and it just amplifies the issues. Now, here is the absolute worst part about this whole entire situation. If you get banned for being underage, you have to do the following. You need to take a photo of yourself that includes you holding the following items: a photo ID that contains your date of birth, and a piece of paper that shows your full Discord tag. Now, I'm not a tinfoil hat kind of guy, but I do not at all feel comfortable giving Discord my ID just to appeal my Discord account that got falsely banned. Do I sound like a 12-year-old? To even further prove that I am an old geezer, what if I told you that I had the original DS when it came out? I got it on the Christmas of the year that it came out, and it was the best Christmas of all time. Even if you do send Discord your fantastic ID, well, they ignore it as well. This person here got their account deactivated for being underage 2 weeks ago. They sent in the request containing their ID to Discord support, and they got nothing. But dear cutie pie viewer, on Discord, if you get banned for anything, this is a super cool infinite money Discord account glitch. If you get banned for anything, whether it be fraud, being a creep, or being falsely reported for being underage, you can just make a new account with no problems whatsoever. You might need a VPN. This would be a great VPN transition, but you can just make a new account. And finally, moving on, if you thought things couldn't get any worse, well, Discord now has a support Twitter account, because more support obviously means more better. Yeah, I'm kind of confused why Discord did this, but in terms of confusion, people are confused. What do you talk to Discord support about? What do they help with? I'm just going to be a professional big gamer for Discord and make their jobs ever so slightly easier by telling you, what can you report to this Twitter account? Well, this Twitter account is good for basic troubleshooting, bugs, email email verification issues, questions related to features or promotions, connection issues, launch updates, and feedback. Oh, they're going to be flooded with people upset about the new username system. But in terms of everything else, like things you actually talk to Discord Trust and Safety about, so hacked accounts, disabled or banned accounts, well, Twitter's not going to do anything and you're going to have to stick with the Trust and Safety that just ignores us every single day of our lives. So anyways, I don't know if this Twitter will make things better or worse. It'll probably just confuse people and make it significantly worse, but that's just my opinion, and that's all I really have, cutie patooties. I love you very much. Have a fantastic day. Mwah!